What is up, people? Welcome back to another Champion Spotlight. In this Champion Spotlight video, I'll be talking about Zach, the secret weapon. As usual, if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below. Peace. What is up, people? It is around that time where we get a new champion in League of Legends, and this video is again a new champion spotlight by me for the champion known as Zach, the secret weapon. I'm just gonna show the recommended items that Riot kind of suggests for you, his skills, and finally what I think about this champion after using him in a game online. Alright guys, so this is the actual recommended build that they recommend for Zach. They're gonna start off with the machete and potions, which I would recommend for any jungler to start out with realistically. The thing about Zach is that you're gonna need your movement speed, so that's why boots of mobility are there. He is a really slow champion, and if you're gonna have any luck with ganks, you are gonna need these boots for sure. They have the Spirit Visage, and they have the Spirit Stone, which is another recommended jungler build. The thing that's interesting here, and because you are going to need to slow people down, they have Rylai's, which is something I recommend. Then they have the Spear of the Spectral Wraith and the Abyssal Scepter. They also have the Aegis of Legion, which I haven't personally got yet, but the Warmogs is a definite must because all your skills take away a little bit of health from Zach. So having the Warmogs is going to give you that extra 1000 health and restore 1% of maximum health every 5 seconds. That's definitely an item you want to get. And then they have the Sunfire Cape if the game goes on long enough, or if you're just doing really well, you could get that as well. Spirit of the Ancient Golem is also a good thing to get. I haven't gotten it personally, but the thing that I usually recommend to rush is especially the Boots of Mobility, Rylai's, and the Warmogs. Once I got that, it was pretty much a done deal. I'm gonna get my health back, I'm able to slow so that other people can get the kill, and you can move fast with the Boots of Mobility. So this is a pretty good build already. Usually the builds that they've been recommending for these new champions is typically what you should be going for, but you can mix in the Spirit Visage if you want to get that for the magic resistance and things like that. Maybe a Frozen Mallet, I don't know, you can mix and match it, but definitely Boots of Mobility, Rylai's, and the Warmogs is the items to get. Zach's passive is Cell Division. Each time Zach hits an enemy with an ability, he sheds a chunk of himself that can be reabsorbed to restore 24 health, which is also 4% of maximum health. The interesting thing about this passive is upon taking fatal damage, Zach splits into 4 Bloblets that attempt to recombine. If any of the Bloblets remain after 8 seconds, if your team actually has your back for those 8 seconds, he will revive with 10 to 50% health, depending on the health of the surviving Bloblets, and there are 4 of them. This passive you may not notice right away, but as soon as you really start hitting things, pieces of you will start falling off, and you can collect those to actually get a little bit of health back, which is why getting things like the Warmogs, like I explained in the item build, is very important. As far as the fatal damage goes and actually surviving with the Bloblets, it's happened to me once, and that's because I wasn't the main focus of the battle. I actually got picked off to the side in the river while everything was going on in mid lane. The chances of you surviving and actually reconstructing yourself with the Bloblets are really slim. It's like winning the lottery because it's really easy. You could usually do one auto attack to kill a Bloblet. There's only 4, and if that's happening in a team fight or even a 1v1, they're gonna kill you. So try not to die too much, because the chances of you actually coming back are really, really rare. In the event that you do, you will notice that you actually do have a great amount of health back. So there is a pro and a con, but I think as far as the fatal part of this passive goes, it's actually not that reliable, so try not to die too much. Zach's Q is Stretching Strike. He smacks enemies, dealing 70 plus 8 magic damage and slowing them by 20% for 2 seconds. I feel like this is his most important skill. This is the skill that's going to be doing the most when it comes to team fights or 1v1s in any situation. It's basically a move that does damage, but it slows them by 20% as said in the actual description. But the thing about this move is that this is really the only move that's going to deal a decent amount of damage, because his W and his E, which I'll explain, even his alt in most cases, don't really do as much as you think it would. The interesting thing about this skill, and like I mentioned, his moves actually do a percentage of his health instead of mana or rage or tenacity or anything like that. This move does 6% of the current health. When stacked up with his passive, he can get that health back after doing that move. Even an auto attack will give him that health back. So the thing about this move that you're really gonna want to pay attention to is that it actually does slow. In a team fight, this is the move that you're probably gonna break into first or second. The E is actually a move you could break into first, but I'll explain that when I get there. but always prioritize maxing this move first out of everything else. Zac's W is Unstable Matter. Zac's body erupts, dealing 40 magic damage plus 4 of the enemy's maximum health as magic damage to all nearby enemies. The max is 200 damage against minions and monsters. This also does 4% of his current health. However, the nice thing about this move is every time you hit something with it, you get a Bloblet off of you that could actually heal you for doing that move. So in a way, you could look at it as if you do the damage of this move, you do the damage to yourself, and you get your health back. So there really is no negative to doing this move. You're always going to have that health that you started off with if you collect the Bloblet. This move doesn't do too much damage, but in a team fight, if you're the one being focused, and even if you're not being the one focused, this is actually a really good move to do. This is kind of like the finishing move. I think in an actual team fight, you would use other moves first and then this one last because of how much damage it doesn't do, but how useful it is just to have an extra move doing damage and automatically giving you a Bloblet to heal with. Zac's E is Elastic Slingshot. He charges up and launches toward a target area, knocking up enemies. Zac faces the cursor and charges up over 1 second. Reactivating this ability again launches him toward his target, dealing 80 plus 11 magic damage to all enemies hit and knocking them back for 0.5 seconds. It can also be cancelled by moving. The interesting thing about this move, just like the other ones, is that it does 12% of your current health instead of mana, tenacity, and rage. This is the move that you're probably going to use first when going into a team fight. Again, probably the second most useful skill aside from the Q, because you could do this in a bush. You could also do this to hop over walls, and it will obviously give you a Bloblet to heal with as well. I'm not too sure, I'd have to look into it a little bit more, but I think that whenever you actually find a Bloblet, it is the amount of health that you used for that move, so you actually get that health back. But in a team fight or even a gank, you're definitely going to want to use this to hop towards the enemy since you are so slow in the beginning, and then you can finish it off with your Q and your W. Hopefully your teammate is also doing moves themselves, and it will more often than not result in an actual kill. So this is the second move I would recommend maxing: first your Q, then this E, because that is the primary moves when ganking and dealing team fight damage. Zac's alt is Let's Bounce. This has no cost and it causes Zac to bounce 4 times, knocking up and slowing enemies. Each bounce deals 160 plus 4 magic damage to nearby enemies, knocks them up for 1 second and slows them by 20% for 1 second. Enemies hit more than once take half damage and are not knocked up or slowed. Zac gains an accelerating movement speed buff 20 to 50% while active. And if you right click this, you can move while in the air. So this is extremely, extremely useful. This is the finishing move that you would do aside from the W just to deal that extra damage. The combination that I like to do is I use the E to actually slingshot myself to the enemy, then I slow them with the Q, and then use Let's Bounce to deal a couple hits of damage. By then, if you're in a team fight, in which you should be, either a gank or a team fight, that combined with your teammate doing their skills will definitely result in a kill. This is very hard to escape once you get it in, but on the other side, it's really hard to get done because Zac is so slow and this is actually really easy to dodge. It may not do too much damage without your full build or even half of that build, so don't rely on it to get a kill. It's not like most alts, it's no cost on your health, but it is extremely useful when you're trying to gank or participate in a team fight. Alright guys, so that is my champion spotlight for Zac. At first, to be honest with you, I was completely turned off of this champion. My first game with him wasn't really too great. I actually jumped in there unaware that he was even a jungler and I had to go through a game without Smite. So trying it out a couple other times, I've played him about 2 or 3 times now, and he actually is a good champion. I was actually in a game talking to someone who was complaining about him on the other side because I did play blind pick just to get into it quickly. And I actually had enough experience at that point to tell him, like, you can't play this champion like you play other junglers. This guy's completely unique, both looks and mechanics. He's one of those champions that you really need to figure it out before you can get confident with it. And once you get all these items in his recommended item that I've recommended to you guys, pretty much the Boots of Mobility, Warmogs, Rylai's, even Abyssal, things like that will just make him incredibly, incredibly good, especially in team fights. That's where he thrives. If you just do your leap into the enemy and then do the slow, your other people can get in there and do some serious damage. So I do actually like this champ after trying him out a couple times. At first I didn't. Maybe that's the route you're gonna take when you first play him, but he is good, much like all the others that have been coming out since Vi. The champions just keep getting better and better. The only thing I'm worried about is that he just doesn't look like he fits in this game. He looks like somebody who belongs in another game that they just kind of ported into League of Legends. But aside from that, his animations are good. Everything's good. I recommend this champion also. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below. And if you follow my League of Legends regular game series, then let me know who to use in my next League of Legends video. Peace. Now put your hands up. Now put your hands up.